Hello again, guys. So what's next? Go to our Photoshop. I'm now going to put in our image. So same practice or same methods. We're just going to have a new container. Div class container. You can have 12 or 16. It is a container of 12. And then going to create the closing tag. Put a wee return in there. Div class grid 12, I think it was. Let me alt tab over. Yes, 12. And then I'm going to close that. Inside the div tag, I'm going to insert our image. So insert image. And where is it? Main art here. Hit OK. Again, this is not my artwork. OK. Hit OK. To design, and we have something like this. Now we do have a gap in there. Now it's up to you if you want the gap. If you do, there are a number of ways of doing it. One method I'm going to do is literally just have this slice here. Okay, I'm just going to create that slice if it didn't already. I'm just going to check that and put that slice in essentially. Slightly bad practice, but let me just get up our images. I think it's one of these ones. Well, no, it's 300 pixels long. It should be 940. So in Photoshop, I'm just going to create a new slice here. Da-da-da-da. Black. Now, obviously, whenever we put a background in, you'll want to change the color of this, but for the time being, this is fine. Double click here. I'm going to call this, I don't know, return image, as if it was hitting the return key or something. Minimize. Go back in. I just had an epiphany here. Maybe if we just put a container above my work. So div class container 12, close and see what happens. No, nothing happened. We should have had a wee container in there, but no matter. Or do we need the grid as well? Let's check this. So we need div class grid of 12. Oh yes, we do have a little gap now, so we could use that, you know. It's not too bad. In fact, you know what, I'm going to go with that. Because what I want is to have a background image, actually. That seems to work. I want to have a background color, and just to fill, you know, over this. And that, I think that's going to work quite nice. Okay, so back into code. What's the next part? Gonna have another gap, so I'm literally going to copy and paste that in. I am then going to copy this one. See, now you can copy and paste it, but instead of a grid 12, we're gonna have a grid 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to get rid of this image, or I'm going to design mode. I can click this image and browse for file, change the file. So it was the Poseidon guy. This buckaroo. Oh, that didn't change it, so I'm gonna just delete it. Go back into code. And then here, just insert it again. Insert image. Hit OK. Check in design, perfect. I am then going to, I'm not going to make a new container, I'm just going to go straight ahead. Put in another div. Oops, shouldn't have done that. Let me just double check what I've got here. So that's, it'd be nice if this was like other programs where this would actually highlight here where that it's ending, it's corresponding. But no, I want to put in a div class grid 4, like so. Stick an image in here, insert image. What's the next one? It's the shieldy guy. Again, it's not my artwork. Okay, and lastly, another div class. Grid 14, that'd be hilarious. Grid 4. And this is going to be insert image again. Bulldogs go in there. Okay, it's a good idea now to actually save the work. File, save all, and check this in design. Alright, so we're getting there. It's pretty cool. Let me see, what could we do next? That's pretty much my design, actually. You know? What you would then do is you would clone this index page so it has all the, like, the CSS and the links and stuff, and you would just, I would keep these bars, get rid of this and just put my own content in there. But part of this homepage template, I'm also going to put in my I'm not going to put my copyright, it's not my work, but you know how you would put text at the end. Okay, so we could have another div class, you guessed it, container 12. Close that off. And inside here, div class grid 12 should work fine. What? I've lost grid 12. And in here, I just want standard text, so paragraph. Could maybe have it a header or something. In here, not my own work. Save all. Design mode. We just need to make sure that is in the center. Now we could use, we will probably use CSS later to fix that. But if you were to write something else in paragraph, you know, maybe on a different page, then that will also be centered. Okay. So you just got to be careful with that. If you want the copyright symbol, you go into your character map and you look for it right there. So you'd copy that wee boy and you would paste them in. I'm not going to paste it because that might work. Remember, you can type in the designer view, which is really, really cool, really powerful. Obviously you would take some time in designing your website, you know, you would make it as crappy as mine, but you know, it's all about, when it comes to portfolio sites, it's all about the graphics, okay, all about the visuals. So obviously to do that, you have to have decent work. Well, you have to have work on it, okay. I don't think any of my work's decent, so you know. So yeah, that's the index page. So next we'll probably do the About Me page. So thank you for watching.